The Dr. Sebi Self-Healing Bible, 13-in-1, the most updated herbalist's guide to Dr. Sebi plant-based alkaline diet and non-toxic lifestyle to restore the body to optimal health and wellness. Written by Zachary Morris. Narrated by Paul Lazer.
Introduction. Who was Dr. Sebi? Dr. Sebi, sometimes known as Alfred Bowman, was a self-taught herbalist from Honduras. He traveled to the United States and received insufficient care for several chronic illnesses, including obesity, diabetes, asthma, and weakness. He was finally healed by a Mexican herbalist who also inspired him to develop his herbal mixtures, which he called Dr. Sebi's self-food. Many people thought Dr. Sebi's theories were harmful and his life was chaotic. He dared to openly claim that he could discover a cure for life-threatening diseases such as cancer, AIDS, and diabetes that had eluded medical science for years. Initially, he stated that his herbs could treat long-term conditions such as lupus, AIDS, and sickle cell anemia. He was imprisoned in 1987 for practicing medicine without a license. However, the court acquitted him. After the state of New York filed another case a few years later, Sebi agreed to stop advertising his drugs as cure-alls. Dr. Sebi's main objective was to convince people to adopt a healthy lifestyle and recognize the value of alkaline foods and a well-balanced diet. He faced criticism because some believed he was trying to deceive them into turning vegan. But as people witnessed the success of his methods, he rose to fame as one of the most well-known herbalists in the world. A legal case was pursued on one of the various accusations made against Dr. Sebi. The assertion was made in a reaction to a 1988 commercial that suggested 4 patients had died. The court intended to imprison him because they thought they had a compelling case. However, 77 individuals testified in court claiming to have recovered after adhering to Dr. Sebi's recommendations and adopting his diet. 77 individuals, according to the witnesses, found him not guilty. They also stressed his eating plan as a medical marvel, yet it was unappreciated. Despite the scandal, Steven Seagal, John Travolta, and Michael Jackson were among Sebi's purported clients. While incarcerated in Honduras, Dr. Sebi developed pneumonia and starved to death while being treated for it. Even though life went on, Dr. Sebi and his extraordinary healing talents were never forgotten. The teachings of Dr. Sebi. When toxins and mucus build up inside the body, it becomes more susceptible to illness. Dr. Sebi asserted that those suffering from various ailments and those involved in disease prevention should always consume an alkaline diet. The body becomes disease-free as the increasing amount of acidic chemicals and mucus is eliminated. He also claimed that any treatment plan for a body illness must include cleansing and detoxification. This assists the body in becoming disease-free by removing excess acidic chemicals and mucus from the liver, lungs, and many other bodily organs. Dr. Sebi also used herbs that benefited the body's revitalization and recharging. When a person's health improves, their organs perform properly, indicating they are disease-free. Dr. Sebi had a critical outlook on this school of medicine. He respected the procedure and did not discount its importance, but believed it was inefficient at addressing the infection's fundamental cause. Western medicine focuses on treating diseases' outward symptoms and attempts to eradicate them, but neglects to take a more comprehensive approach. Dr. Sebi examined diets and food sources because he believed that many ailments might be prevented by respecting the body and giving it the correct vitamins and minerals. According to Dr. Sebi's theory, the disease's primary cause and genesis are a weakening of the body's mucous membrane. He believed his African bio-mineral balancing approach of providing the body with the necessary nutrients could reverse the membrane's weakening and disintegration. Most of these alkalinity nutrients are found in naturally occurring plants. Alkalizing the environment, according to the theory that illnesses thrive in acidic environments, significantly weakens the sickness. Inorganic compounds frequently affect the body's acidity. Worse, if they contain an acid base, they can exacerbate the acidity. Dr. Sebi believed that using natural and organic botanical treatments regularly could cleanse and detoxify the body, reduce the effects of its more alkaline state, and repair the mucous membrane. According to Dr. Sebi, the nutritional system also replenishes minerals lost over time and removes poisons accumulated over a lifetime. It is thought that returning the body to an alkaline state can repair cell damage caused by an acidic environment. Toxins are difficult to eliminate once removed from the major organs. Toxins in the body frequently circulate through the skin, gallbladder, lymph nodes, kidneys, and colon before being eliminated. Because of the long-term effects of these toxins, the smallest and weakest organs in the human body are usually the first to show signs of degeneration. Cleaning, detoxifying, or treating the gut is only one battle aspect. The other organs can still harbor poisons and be affected by them. As a result, a more comprehensive approach is required. Many doctors oppose Dr. Sebi's use of herbal treatments and altered diets to treat disease. Because it is not taught in Western medical schools, its credibility is not as established. Nonetheless, many claim that Dr. Sebi's techniques have improved their health. Dr. Sebi's alkaline diet is lovely and simple because it is doable and long-lasting. All that is required is a refocus on our food intake. A trip to the grocery store is required for minor ailments. No invasive procedures or expensive pharmaceuticals are required. Dr. Sebi's influence lives on even after his death, thanks to alternative nutrition and herbal treatments that are gaining traction and popularity. Dr. Sebi was an inspiration to many and worked as an herbalist his entire life. His alkaline diet is a wonderful way to remember his legacy and a simple technique for regaining control of your body and mind. This book is intended to help you get started on the Dr. Sebi diet by providing instructions on how to do so. All nutrients will alert you if you are not eating more than your nutritional guide recommends. You must choose which supplements to take. Book 1, Dr. Sebi's Treatments. Chapter 1, Dr. Sebi's Treatment Philosophy. Without a doubt, we eat very differently today than we did previously. People used to eat plants and animals, but how agriculture is presented has significantly changed our eating habits. For example, we provided grains, and the consumption of salt, sugar, and meat has increased. Also popular are cheddar, milk, and other milk products. When these foods are digested, absorbed, and metabolized by the body, they produce a significant amount of acid in the blood. This simply means that the acidity of our diet has risen. Choosing fruits and vegetables with the least amount of acid is terrible. According to Dr. Sebi's alkaline diet, our eating habits should be alkaline. According to Dr. Sebi, our blood should maintain its normal pH range of 7.35 to 7.45. Advertisers for the alkaline diet claim that eating foods that produce acid disrupt this balance, resulting in the loss of important nutrients such as calcium, potassium, salt, and magnesium. As a result, people become more susceptible to illness. An acid-forming diet depletes the body's supplements of catalysts, reducing neuronal energy levels. The processing quality will likely suffer when the chemical supply runs out. As a result, the minerals and nutrients required for optimal performance, quality, and health are deficient. Similarly, the alkaline reserves in the tissues and bones are depleted, increasing the risk of injuries or other health problems. Furthermore, a high acid diet raises uric acid levels, which can lead to the formation of uric crystals. These crystals can cause bursitis or arthritis, causing joint pain and inflammation. Cleansing and detoxification, key to reversing disease. Detoxification, also known as detox, is a popular term. In most cases, it refers to following a specific diet or using specific items that promise to cleanse your body of toxins, improve your health, and aid in weight loss. Toxins can be removed from your body without using specialized diets or expensive pills. You can, however, aid your body's natural detoxification process. Some people believe that a full-body detox will help the body remove toxins. It may be necessary to take vitamins, fast, follow a diet, or use a sauna. Potential risks. Some detoxes are harmful to people's health, according to the National Center for Complementary and Integrative Health, because they encourage them to. Reduced food consumption leads to a lack of essential nutrients. Excessive juice or tea consumption may result in a dangerous electrolyte imbalance. Drinking oxalate-rich juices may increase your risk of kidney problems. Avoid severe diarrhea and dehydration and use detox solutions such as laxatives. Experiment with diets that exacerbate underlying illnesses like diabetes. Because some detox products contain harmful or illegal ingredients, the Food and Drug Administration, FDA, and the Federal Trade Commission, FTC, have taken action against marketing companies. Before using supplements, detox products, or new diets, people should always consult a doctor or a dietitian. Benefits of Dr. Sebi's treatments. People dieting will benefit greatly from Dr. Sebi's diet. While the foods recommended by Dr. Sebi's diet have a reputation for reducing inflammation, there are other benefits to following them. Aid in weight loss. While this diet is not designed to aid in weight loss, it can help those who want to lose weight. According to research, people who consume an unlimited whole plant-based diet lose significant weight. The high-fiber, low-calorie foods recommended play a role in how people lose weight on this diet. Except for avocados, nuts, seeds, and oil, most of Dr. Sebi's recommended foods are low in calories. Even if you eat nuts and seeds, they are high in fiber and minerals in addition to calories. Better colon health. This diet also benefits your colon because it encourages the consumption of various fruits and vegetables. Constipation does not occur in people who follow the Dr. Sebi diet because fiber-rich. Appetite control. Although many believe this diet is very restrictive regarding calories, studies show that it can help with appetite control. Your food's high fiber content can increase satiety and keep you feeling fuller for longer. Improved gut microbiome. The stomach functions as the body's second brain. Gut microbes produce enzymes and molecules that affect your health and mood. What you eat impacts the molecules that microbes release into your bloodstream. The food you eat can influence the microbes in your stomach. For example, consuming greasy, fatty, and processed foods has been shown in studies to reduce good microorganisms and promote the growth of harmful bacteria in the body. Reduced inflammation. Although inflammation is one of the body's first lines of defense in detecting infection and disease, low-level chronic inflammation is also harmful to the body. Diabetes, stroke, and cancer are all diseases caused by chronic inflammation. Thus, eating many fruits and vegetables has been linked to less oxidative, stress-induced inflammation. According to studies, individuals who consume plant-based foods have a 31% lower risk of developing heart disease and cancer than those who consume animal products. The 7-day liver detox diet plan. From day 1 to 3, you can only drink fluids. Individuals following this diet drink only fresh lime juice and plenty of water. This is one of the most difficult stages because the person is fasting and will feel weak and tired. Individuals on the liver detox diet can engage in light exercise if they desire. It is critical to allow yourself plenty of time to rest and not overdo it. From day 4 to day 6, the liver detox diet is much easier. These days, any homemade food grown from the ground is permissible. Steamed vegetables and whole grain products are also permitted. While certain foods may be consumed during this stage of the detox diet, the individual must continue to drink plenty of fluids. This menu phase permits juice, homegrown teas, and handcrafted soil juices. On day 7, the foods considered on days 4 through 6 can be eaten. Steaming vegetables is an alternative to eating them raw or bubbled. For this diet phase, the herbs rosemary and dandelion are recommended. While a liver detox diet can help the liver eliminate toxins from the body, it can also have negative side effects. Dieters should consult with their primary care physician before beginning this type of purging. If a person experiences symptoms like retching or pain, they should stop eating immediately and seek medical attention. Dr. Sebi on mucus and diseases. Dr. Sebi was pivotal in establishing the link between mucus and disease and the significance of an alkaline diet. The Western diet must be altered, which has become popular and globalized. Genetically modified and hybridized plant foods, processed foods, dairy, and meat are all part of the Western diet. It is time to prioritize a diet rich in alkaline plant foods. Most of the time, healing begins with removing foods that introduce pathogens and toxins into the body, acidifying it. Unfortunately, this results in chronic inflammation, mucus buildup, illness, and disease development. According to a World Health Organization report, red meat consumption is probably carcinogenic, causes cancer to humans. In contrast, processed meat consumption is carcinogenic to humans, which means it can cause or have a high propensity to cause cancer in humans. Numerous scientific studies have also found that animal fat and protein raise the risk of diabetes, heart disease, cancer, and other chronic diseases. We should return to a diet composed of organic, natural, whole, and non-hybrid plant foods to assist the human body and facilitate the healing and homeostasis of each organ in the body and its functioning. According to Dr. Sebi, this is the foundation for healing and health in the body. Furthermore, returning to the use of natural, alkaline, non-hybrid plant herbs to reverse complex diseases and promote rapid healing is critical. Dr. Sebi was aware of this, which is why he was instrumental in establishing and reinforcing the idea that natural, alkaline, non-hybrid plant foods had a chemical, phylogenic relationship with the human body and improved healing. His book, African Bimineral Balance Healing Methodology, is based on the premise that food that causes mucus overproduction and increases acidity in the body is the source of all diseases. Toxic-laden and acidic foods attack the body constantly and cause a prolonged inflammatory response, leading to chronic inflammation. Acute inflammation is a healthy, natural process that the body uses to fight infections and repair physical damage. When acute inflammation becomes chronic, the normally beneficial and natural process starts attacking healthy cells all over the body, resulting in various diseases. This development includes forming the protective mucous membrane that forms the organs and promotes the production of excess mucus, which jeopardizes the health of the body's other organs. So, what can we do to stop this? We avoid this by removing such foods from the diet and substituting natural, alkaline, non-hybrid plant foods. All acidic hybrid plant foods, processed foods, dairy, and meat must be avoided. The best way to start incorporating these foods into your diet is to review Dr. Sebi's list of alkaline foods. When the human body becomes acidic, it becomes more susceptible to disease. When the body becomes acidic, the mucous membrane that protects the organs becomes weakened, resulting in chronic inflammation and disease. Although different pH levels are recommended for different body parts, we are strongly advised to consume alkaline foods with pH levels between 7.35 and 7.45, preferably 7.4, which the body also maintains in the blood. The ability of a molecule to attract hydrogen ions is known as its pH, which stands for potential hydrogen. The lower the pH level, the more hydrogen is available. The available hydrogen, on the other hand, decreases as the pH rises. The pH scale ranges from 0 to 14. Acidic levels are represented by numbers ranging from 0 to 6, with 0 being the most acidic. The neutral level is 7, and the alkaline level is 8 to 14, with 14 being the highest. Here's a quick rundown of their body's organs and their pH levels. Blood. The blood has a pH level that ranges between the scale of 7.35 and 7.45. Intestines. While the large intestine has a pH level between 5.7 and 6.7, the small intestine has a pH between 6 and 7.4. Vagina. The vagina has a pH level that ranges around 4.5. This is to protect the vagina against microbial overgrowth. Skin. The inner layer of the skin has a pH level that ranges around 6.9. In contrast, the outer layer of the skin has a pH level of around 4 to help protect itself from the bacteria in the environment. Stomach. The stomach has a pH level that ranges between the scale of 1.35 and 3.5. However, the mucous neck cells located right below the stomach's lining surface have a neutral pH. Despite these differences in body parts and pH levels, blood is an element of equilibrium and balance in the human body to maintain homeostasis. Homeostasis refers to the body's tendency to maintain a relatively stable balance of interdependent elements. The body works tirelessly to maintain this stable balance by supplying organs with the necessary nutrients to heal and remain healthy. Before the human body can even consider maintaining homeostasis, it must constantly maintain a pH of 7.4. Metabolic acidosis occurs when the body's pH drops below 7.4, resulting in shock and death. As a result, to reduce the amount of hydrogen in the blood, the body must maintain a slightly alkaline state. Excess hydrogen in the blood contributes to hemoglobin depletion in red blood cells and impairs nutrient and oxygen delivery to the body's cells. This also jeopardizes metabolic functions and organ health. The body has several buffering systems to keep the pH at 7.4. When the body is bombarded with acidic foods regularly, the buffering systems go into overdrive and become overworked. To maintain the blood's pH level of 7.4, the body will attempt to remove alkaline materials, such as calcium, from fluids and bones throughout the body. This compromises metabolic function and jeopardizes organ health, leading to chronic diseases such as liver disease, high blood pressure, heart disease, kidney disease, and osteoporosis. Alkaline plant herbs and foods keep blood pH stable without jeopardizing organ and metabolic functions or overcompensating by removing alkalis from the body. Chapter 2, Fasting to Prevent All Diseases. Self-sufficiency, disease recovery, and quality of life are all influenced by nutritional status. Obesity can be caused by overeating, poor dietary habits, or other metabolic, genetic, and behavioral flaws that result in insulin resistance and pancreatic beta cell dysfunction. As a result, this is thought to be the root cause of type 2 diabetes. Intermittent fasting, in which people fast on consecutive or alternating days, has been shown to reduce the risk of type 2 diabetes and increase the risk of cardiovascular disease. Fasting periods imposed on laboratory animals appear to improve survival, promote health, and reduce illness, including multiple morbidities associated with neurological cancer disorders and circadian rhythm disorders. Fasting is used in religion. Fasting usually lasts 3 weeks. During Ramadan, all Muslims worldwide fast during the daytime of the ninth month of the Muslim calendar, which is considered one of Muslims' five critical pillars. Fasting has been shown to reduce inflammation, increase pro-inflammatory immune cells and cytokines, raise circulating lipids and glucose levels, and lower blood pressure. Human and animal experiments have also revealed that fuel selection is altered, metabolism efficiency improves, and oxidative stress is reduced. Random fasting increases heart rate and blood pressure, lowering circulating triglycerides and cholesterol, and decreases intermedia carotid thickness in animal models. It also improves myocardial ischemia survival by having anti-apoptotic, pro-angiogenic, and anti-remodeling properties. Intermittent fasting is also cardioprotective in laboratory animals, providing resistance to ischemic injury due to increased adiponectin levels. Adiponectin is a distinct adipokine with positive effects on body composition, but negative effects on circulation levels. Intermittent fasting lowers visceral fat and adipokines such as IL-6, IGF-1, TNF-alpha, and leptin. Although Ramadan fasting is required for all Muslims who value the religious atmosphere during the month of Ramadan, the Quran forbids fasting for those who are sick, traveling, expectant mothers, mothers who are breastfeeding, or females during their menstrual cycle. Fasting in particular can be dangerous for diabetics because it increases the risk of postprandial hyperglycemia, dehydration, hypoglycemia, and thrombosis, both in the presence and absence of diabetic ketoacidosis. Fasting intermittently. Intermittent fasting is the practice of not eating during certain clock cycles. Unsweetened tea, water, and black coffee are permitted at all times. Depending on the process, fasting can last between 16 and 24 hours, or 2 days. 500 to 600 calories are consumed in total. The most well-known type of intermittent fasting appears to be the 16-8 method, which involves eating only once a week. 7 different intermittent fasting methods. Intermittent fasting is becoming increasingly popular. However, despite the recent surge in media coverage, it is not new. It is a technique that's been used for health and spiritual reasons for a long time. Intermittent fasting is more than just skipping meals, contrary to popular belief. Instead, it entails paying closer attention to your overall eating routine to get your body into a digestion rhythm. Furthermore, intermittent fasting can help you lose weight, prevent disease, and possibly live longer. There are numerous methods for achieving intermittent fasting, which is fantastic. To accomplish this, you should select the best lifestyle strategy to boost your chances of success. Here are 7 different methods of intermittent fasting that you can try right now. Number 1, the 5-2 fasting. This is one of the most popular intermittent fasting methods. The goal is to eat consistently for 5 days without counting calories, then consume 500 or 600 calories per day for women and men, respectively. Fasting days can be any day of the week. The idea is that fasting for short periods keeps you cooperative. If you get hungry on a fasting day, look forward to the next day when you can feast again. Consider this fasting method if preparing for a cycling or running event or high mileage week. Alternatively, consult with a sports nutritionist. Number 2, time restricted fasting. You choose a daily eating window that ideally leaves a 14-16 hour fasting period with this type of intermittent fasting. Due to hormonal issues, women should not fast for more than 14 hours daily. For example, you could begin your eating window at 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. It may be especially useful for someone with a family who eats dinner early. Most of the fasting time is then spent sleeping. Depending on when you set your window, you may not have to miss any meals. However, this is contingent on your ability to remain consistent. Daily fasting may not be for you if your schedule is constantly changing, or if you require or desire the freedom to go out for breakfast, go on a late date, or attend happy hour on occasion. Number 3, overnight fasting. This is the simplest method, requiring a 12-hour fast every day. Stop eating after supper, for example, at 7 p.m., and then start eating at 7 a.m. the following morning with breakfast. Autophagy occurs around the 12-hour mark, but the benefits are less severe. The main advantage of this fasting method is that it is simple to implement, regardless of your needs or schedule. You also do not need to skip meals. You are eliminating a nighttime snack, if you ate one to begin with. This strategy, however, does not maximize the benefits of fasting. A narrower fasting window implies more time to eat, which may not help you reduce your calorie intake if you're fasting to lose weight. Number 4, eat, stop, eat. This is yet another shocking fact that makes losing weight simple once more. In terms of adaptability, this method differs from others. Fasting is defined as temporary abstinence from food. You commit to a weekly resistance exercise regimen and 1 or 2 24-hour fasts. When your fast is over, normally eat as if it never happened. That's all there is to it. Eating responsibly entails returning to a regular eating pattern. You don't want to binge because you just fasted, but you also don't want to restrict yourself to an extreme diet or eat less than you need. Fasting for 1 or 2 24-hour periods per week allows you to consume slightly more calories on the remaining 5 or 6 non-fasting days. It is easier and more enjoyable to end the week with a calorie deficit rather than feeling obligated to adhere to a strict diet. Number 5, complete day fasting. You eat here only once a day. You won't have another meal until dinner the next day after tonight. The whole day fasting period lasts 24 hours, lunch to lunch, or dinner to dinner, whereas the 5-2 fasting period lasts 36 hours. For example, you could eat supper on Sunday, fast on Monday by consuming only 500 or 600 calories, and then have breakfast on Tuesday. A full day fast for weight loss makes it difficult, but not impossible, to consume all the calories for the day at once. The problem with this approach is that getting all the nutrients your body requires in one meal may be difficult, not to mention how difficult it is to maintain this approach. You may be very hungry by supper, leading you to make calorie-dense food choices. Number 6, alternate day fasting. In this case, you could alternate between eating normally and fasting. A typical fast is 25% of your daily caloric needs, or approximately 500 calories. This is a common weight loss method. Fasting on alternate days, according to studies, significantly reduces body mass index, weight, fat mass, and total cholesterol in overweight people. A previous study found that the negative effects of alternate day fasting, such as hunger, faded by week 2, and people began to feel more satisfied with the diet by week 4. The disadvantage was that the research participants reported that they were never truly full during the 8 weeks of the experiment, making it difficult to stick to this technique. Number 7, choose your day fasting. This is a more free-form approach to intermittent fasting. We recommend doing time-restricted fasting. Fast for 16 hours, eat for 8, once or twice a week. You might not normally eat until 8 p.m. on Sunday, and then again at noon on Monday. It's the same as skipping breakfast a couple times a week. How to use intermittent fasting the right way, a step-by-step approach. Intermittent fasting involves alternately eating and fasting. People may find it difficult to eat during a limited time each day or to alternate between eating days and not eating days. We'll review how to use intermittent fasting correctly by setting personal goals, planning meals, and calculating calorie needs. Intermittent fasting is a popular method for people to make their lives simpler, lose weight, improve their overall health and well-being. For example, by mitigating the effects of aging. Fasting is generally considered safe for most healthy, well-nourished people. However, it may not be suitable for people who have medical problems. The guidelines below will assist you in making the most of intermittent fasting. Number 1, establish personal objectives. Before you begin intermittent fasting, you should have a goal in mind. This could be to lose weight, become healthier, or improve metabolic health. Your goal will help you decide on the best fasting strategy and how many calories and nutrients you need to consume. Number 2, select a technique. Feel free to experiment with different fasting methods when fasting for health reasons. Choose a strategy that appeals to you and that you believe you can implement. Number 3, determine calorie requirements. Intermittent fasting has no inherent dietary constraints. To control their weight, people who work with a doctor or nutritionist must create a calorie deficit, which means eating fewer calories than they burn. To gain weight, people must consume more calories than they burn. Many tools are available to help people calculate their calorie requirements and determine how many calories they should consume each day to gain, lose, or maintain weight. A person may also seek advice on how many calories they need from a healthcare professional or a dietitian. An expert can help people determine the best foods for them and devise a healthy weight loss strategy. Number 4, create a meal plan. People who want to lose or gain weight may find that planning their meals for their day or week is beneficial. Meal preparation does not have to be time-consuming. It considers both calorie and nutrient intake. For example, the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, CDC, trusted source promotes the My Plate Plan, which shows a person's dietary category objectives for each day. Meal planning has several benefits, including assisting a person in sticking to a calorie count and ensuring they have the necessary supplies for dishes, quick meals, and snacks. Meal planning may also assist consumers in wasting less food and thus saving money. Number 5, make every calorie count. All calories are not created equal. Although these fasting methods do not limit the number of calories consumed during eating intervals, the nutritional content of the food must be considered. Trusted sources should consume nutrient-dense diets or high amounts of nutrients per calorie. They do not have to completely avoid less nutritious foods, but they should exercise in moderation and focus on healthier options to reap the most benefits. Is it advisable to try intermittent fasting? Scientists have been studying the potential benefits of calorie restriction for a long time. Although the results appear indifferent, excessive calorie restriction is harmful, especially for athletes. This is where intermittent fasting can help. It's a case of having your cake and eating it. While there is more to it, intermittent fasting focuses on your body's absorption. You're conditioning your body to become fat adapted without starving it. Your body can burn glucose or fat. Becoming fat acclimated means that the body prefers to use fat as fuel rather than carbs broken down into glucose. Intermittent fasting, in essence, should improve your body's ability to burn fat. Intermittent fasting has far more scientifically proven benefits than most of us know. Furthermore, the research appears to be promising. Because everyone is different, intermittent fasting will have a different impact on different people. Nonetheless, intermittent fasting works best when combined with self-awareness and the guidance of a nutritionist. Some people may become stressed as a result. So, you should honestly assess where you are with your nutrition and what your goals are. You may employ various strategies if you believe they will help manage your health. Benefits of intermittent fasting. Intermittent fasting, according to research, does more than just burn fat. Changes in this metabolic switch impact the body and brain, such as living longer, slimmer, and having a sharper intellect. Several things happen during intermittent fasting that can protect organs from chronic illnesses, such as type 2 diabetes, heart disease, age-related neurological disorders, even inflammatory bowel disease, and many cancers. Here are some of the benefits of intermittent fasting that have thus far been discovered. Number 1, memory and thinking. According to research, intermittent fasting improves working memory in humans and verbal memory in adults. Number 2, cardiovascular health. Intermittent fasting increases blood pressure, resting heart rate, and other heart-related measures. Number 3, physical ability. Fasting for 16 hours reduced fat while retaining muscle mass in young males. Mice fed on alternate days have more endurance when running. Number 4, obesity and type 2 diabetes. In animals, intermittent fasting prevented obesity. Obese adults lost weight by intermittent fasting in 6 brief experiments. Most existing data suggests that intermittent fasting can help patients lose body weight and lower their fasting glucose, fasting insulin, and leptin levels while lowering insulin resistance, decreasing leptin levels, and increasing adiponectin levels. According to some studies, some patients who practiced intermittent fasting under the supervision of their doctors could eliminate their need for insulin medication. Number 5, tissue well-being. Intermittent fasting decreased tissue damage and enhanced surgical outcomes in rats. Side effects of intermittent fasting. It is easier to restrict calories a few days a week to a smaller eating window each day than to moderately determine calories at each meal. Fasting for longer periods, more than the average time between meals, stimulates cellular repair, improves insulin sensitivity, raises human growth hormone levels, and changes gene expression to promote longevity and disease prevention. But are there any risks? Here are some of the drawbacks of intermittent fasting. Number 1, intermittent fasting may cause nausea. People who fast for an extended period may experience headaches, tiredness, crankiness, and constipation. To reduce some of these negative side effects, you may want to switch from fasting to periodic fasting or time-restricted eating plans that allow you to eat every day within a set time frame. Number 2, it may lead to overeating. Because fasting causes your appetite hormones and the hunger center in your brain to go into overdrive, there is a strong biological urge to overeat following fasting periods. Individuals naturally desire to reward themselves after completing extremely difficult tasks, such as exercising or fasting for an extended period. A 2018 study found that the two most common side effects of calorie-restricted diets, slowed metabolism, and increased appetite are just as likely when people practice intermittent fasting as when they reduce calories daily. According to time-restricted eating research, eating out of sync with a person's circadian rhythm, your body's normal daily cycle, may lead to metabolic problems. Number 3, intermittent fasting may result in excessive weight loss in elderly persons. While intermittent fasting appears to have promise, there is little data on its benefits or how it may affect older people. For the most part, human research has concentrated on small groups of young or middle-aged people for brief periods. Number 4, it might be harmful if you are on certain drugs. If you want to try intermittent fasting, consult with your doctor first. Skipping meals and drastically reducing calories can be dangerous for people with certain diseases, such as diabetes. Some patients who take blood pressure or heart disease medications may be more susceptible to sodium, potassium, and other mineral imbalances during extended fasting periods. Another concern is that people who must take their medications with food to avoid nausea or stomach discomfort may have difficulty fasting. When should you avoid intermittent fasting? Intermittent fasting is alternatively fasting, not eating for extended periods, and eating regularly. Two popular intermittent fasting strategies are the 16-18 technique and the 5-2 diet. The 16-8 diet involves fasting for 16 hours and eating for 8 hours every day. The 5-2 diet consists of eating normally 5 days a week and limiting your calorie intake on the other 2 days. Doctors recommend intermittent fasting to improve brain function, reduce inflammation, and lower blood pressure. Intermittent fasting, on the other hand, may be harmful to certain groups of people. You should avoid intermittent fasting if you have any of the following characteristics. Number 1. You have a history of eating disorders or disordered eating. Intermittent fasting necessitates intentional dietary restriction as well as denial of hunger signals. These habits may trigger new eating disorder behaviors if you have an eating disorder. Number 2, you are pregnant, nursing, or attempting to conceive. Pregnant or lactating women require more energy and should avoid calorie restrictions. You should avoid intermittent fasting if you're trying to conceive. Number 3, you have diabetes or other blood sugar problems. Fasting can induce dangerously low blood sugar levels and cause abrupt variations in blood sugar levels. Number 4, you are under the age of 18. Children and teenagers require a lot of calories to properly grow and develop. Due to the risk of low calorie intake, fasting should be avoided if you are still evolving. Number 5, you use drugs for high blood pressure or heart disease. Fasting increases your chances of having dangerously low electrolyte levels in your blood. Fasting may cause low electrolytes in people taking blood pressure or heart disease medications. Electrolytes include substances such as sodium and potassium. Finally, intermittent fasting is not suitable for everyone. Fortunately, several other ways to care for your health do not involve fasting. Frequently asked questions about intermittent fasting. Here are the answers to the most frequently asked questions regarding intermittent fasting. Number 1. Can I drink liquids when fasting? Yes. Water, coffee, tea, and other caloric-free liquids are acceptable. Do not sweeten your coffee. Small quantities of milk or cream may be permissible. Coffee is very useful during a fast since it suppresses appetite. Number 2. Isn't skipping breakfast unhealthy? No. The issue is that most archetypal breakfast skippers lead unhealthy lifestyles. The practice is entirely safe if you consume healthful foods for the remainder of the day. Number 3. Am I allowed to take supplements while fasting? Yes. Keep in mind, however, that some supplements, such as fat-soluble vitamins, may function better when taken with meals. Number 4. Can I work out while I'm fasting? Fast workouts are acceptable. Before a fasting workout, some individuals advocate consuming branched-chain amino acids, BCAAs. Many BCAA products are available on Amazon. Number 5. Will fasting result in muscle loss? All weight loss procedures can result in muscle loss. So, lifting weights and consuming plenty of protein is critical. According to 2011 research, intermittent fasting produces less muscle loss than conventional calorie restriction. Number 6. Will fasting reduce my metabolism? No. Older research indicates that fasting for a short period of time increases metabolism. On the other hand, longer fasts of 3 or more days can reduce metabolism. Number 7. Should children fast? Fasting your children is usually a poor idea. Number 8. What can I consume when fasting intermittently? Water and zero-calorie liquids such as black coffee and tea are permitted while you are not eating. And regularly eating throughout your eating interval does not imply going insane. If you fill your meals with high-calorie junk food, supersized fried foods, and desserts, you're unlikely to lose weight or get healthy. Benefits of fasting. Fasting helps with blood sugar control. Fasting on alternate days improves insulin sensitivity and protects against fatty liver disease. In addition, researchers discovered that fasting mice have fewer fat cells in their pancreas. In a recent study published in a journal, the researchers demonstrated the pathway by which fat cells in the pancreas cause type 2 diabetes. As a recognized and common condition, fatty liver has received extensive research. However, little is known about fat accumulation in the pancreas caused by obesity and its link to type 2 diabetes. Obese mice with diabetes have an abundance of pancreatic fat cells. Due to their genetic sequence, mice resistant to diabetes have almost no pancreatic fat, but an excess of fat in the liver. Fat accumulation in structures other than fat tissue, such as the liver, bones, or even muscles, harms these structures and the body. Fasting decreases pancreatic fat. The experts divided the diabetic-prone overweight animals into two groups. The first was allowed to consume ad libitum, as much as they wanted. The animals in the second group were subjected to a random fasting schedule, in which they were fed an unlimited meal one day and not fed the next. The researchers noticed differences in the last 5 weeks. They concluded that fat cells accumulate in group 1 animals. Fat deposits, however, are uncommon in group 2 animals. Fasting enhances heart health. Fasting can help your heart by lowering blood pressure, cholesterol, and triglyceride levels. Heart disease is a leading cause of death worldwide, accounting for approximately 31.5% of all deaths. One of the most important ways to reduce your risk of heart disease is to change your diet and lifestyle. According to some studies, incorporating fasting into your routine can benefit your heart health. According to research, 8 weeks of intermittent fasting reduces bad LDL cholesterol levels by 25% and blood triglycerides by 32%. Another study of 110 overweight people found that fasting for 3 weeks under medical supervision significantly reduced blood pressure, triglyceride levels, total bad LDL cholesterol, and total cholesterol. Furthermore, fasting was linked to a lower risk of coronary artery disease and a slightly lower risk of diabetes, a risk factor for heart disease, in one study of 4,629 people. Fasting boosts brain function. According to new research, fasting can improve brain function by increasing protein levels, which promotes neuron growth. Diabetes, according to the findings, is linked to the treatment and prevention of age-related neurodegenerative diseases such as Alzheimer's. The researchers examined the neurochemistry and activity of mice's brains during the intermittent fasting and normal eating. Many studies are being conducted on neurodegenerative diseases' molecular and cellular processes. They've also examined how fasting can boost neuronal energy and aid disease resistance. According to previous research, fasting is a brain challenge that activates chemicals that promote neuron efficiency and development. Engaging in strenuous exercise can also have this effect. One specific chemical shift may give neurons more energy while improving their connections to other neurons. Fasting mice had a 50% increase in BDNF, brain-derived neurotrophic factor, which was caused by an increase in beta-hydroxybutyrate in the ketone body, which occurs when fat is burned. The BDNF encourages the formation of new stem cell neurons, increases neuronal connexions, and strengthens synapses. Furthermore, previous research indicates declining BNDF levels are a feature of Alzheimer's disease. Fasted mice showed increased alertness and activation in brain areas associated with learning and memory. Fasting may benefit cognition due to increased nerve cell mitochondria caused by increased BDNF levels. Historically, neurodegeneration has been linked to mitochondrial deficiency or dysfunction in the brain. Increasing the number of mitochondria in neurons improves their ability to shape and sustain synapses and their learning and memory capacity. Fasting delays aging and increases longevity. Fasting causes the production of an anti-aging molecule that keeps blood vessels young. According to new research, fasting activates a molecule that slows the aging of our arteries aging. The findings could help prevent chronic age-related diseases like heart disease, cancer, and Alzheimer's. A molecule produced during fasting that has been discovered to have a new function, it can keep our vascular system young and supple. In a new study, researchers have restored aging symptoms such as wrinkles and hair loss in mice. Another group of researchers has rejuvenated aging human cells even more spectacularly. Fasting or caloric restriction may result in the production of a molecule that slows vascular aging. How fasting and correct diet can slow aging. Vascular aging is a natural part of getting older. The arteries that serve various organs become more vulnerable and resistant to aging damage as people age. Understanding vascular aging requires understanding how to sit. As a result, the researchers decided to concentrate their efforts on vascular aging, cell aging events, and how to avoid them. The researchers found an explicit link between vascular aging and calorie restriction. They used atherosclerosis, mouse models, post-mortem aorta studies, and cell culture experiments. They also malnourished mice and performed similar experiments on them. The hungry mice produced the predicted beta-hydroxybutyrate molecule, according to the researchers. Surprisingly, that compound also inhibited vascular aging. When glucose is in short supply, the liver produces beta-hydroxybutyrate, a ketonic molecule. The body produces ketones during fasting or famine on low-carb diets and after prolonged exercise. The researchers also discovered that beta-hydroxybutyrate encourages blood vessel lining cells to divide and multiply. Cell division indicates cellular youth. The molecule beta-hydroxybutyrate has the potential to slow vascular aging. This establishes a chemical connection between calorie restriction and anti-aging benefits. Endothelial cells that line the inner surface of lymphatic and blood vessels may benefit from this compound in slowing vascular aging. Senescence is an avoidable type of cell aging. The research also revealed that the compound triggers another chain of events that keeps DNA of such endothelial cells intact and young. Book 2, Dr. Sebi's Anxiety Treatments. Chapter 1. What is anxiety? A fearful or anxious reaction to a threat or danger is defined as anxiety. It is a natural response that allows the body to prepare for the threat via adrenaline. On the other hand, anxiety can take over a person, resulting in anxiety neurosis. The person is then labeled as anxious. This could be chronic anxiety, characterized by persistent worry and frequently associated with depression or a panic attack. A panic attack is when panic and dread overtake the individual unexpectedly. When faced with a frightening or dangerous situation, our bodies activate the fight or flight response, causing adrenaline to flood the system and the body to prepare for action. It can also occur when no action is taken and nervous energy is not expelled. Dizziness, vision disturbances, clammy hands, a racing heart, parched lips, and excessive breathing are all symptoms of panic attacks. Up to 70% of panic attack patients visit up to 10 doctors before receiving a proper diagnosis. Women are twice as likely as men to experience anxiety. Furthermore, there is evidence that some people are predisposed biochemically to panic attacks. According to the National Center for Health Statistics, anxiety disorder medications are among the top 20 most prescribed pharmaceuticals. According to the Royal College of Psychiatrists in the United Kingdom, more than 9 million Britons may experience excessive worry. Many psychiatric problems, such as phobias, panic attacks, obsessive-compulsive disorders, and post-traumatic stress disorder, are characterized by anxiety. In comparison, anxiety is a state of worry, fear, or uneasiness. As previously stated, it is entirely natural and human. It is unlikely that our forefathers would have lived as long or as successfully if they had not experienced anxiety. Anxiety at the sight of a prowling lion triggered our forefathers' fight or flight response, allowing them to live another day. Anxiety remains a common emotion today, but the focus has shifted from prowling predators to more abstract and trivial concerns. Bill payments, job-related concerns, loss, or divorce, for example, cause uncertainty and anxiety. Anxiety can be triggered by seemingly insignificant events such as going out, being late, and taking tests. We develop an emotional disorder when we cannot control our worries and concerns. Some people are better at this than others. In those who have normal anxiety responses, the emotion passes quickly. This is much more difficult for those who have an anxiety disorder. The illness can have a devastating effect on all aspects of their daily lives. When anxiety levels reach a certain level, it is considered abnormal and unhealthy. It is considered a disorder when it reaches that point and must be treated as such. But first, we need to dig deeper to understand the problem. An anxiety disorder is defined as excessive anxiety concerning the original stressor. It is the type that takes longer than usual, interfering with normal body functions and, in general, the victim's life. Anxiety disorders can treat high blood pressure, heart attack, stroke, and nausea. When anxiety interferes with certain aspects of a person's life, such as studying, social life, work, and the general inability to complete daily tasks, it becomes a disorder. You may not need to see a doctor or therapist if your abnormal anxiety resolves. If your symptoms persist, you should seek medical attention as soon as possible. You have severe symptoms if you are experiencing extreme stress and cannot carry on with your daily activities. Anxiety symptoms should not be confused with anxiety symptoms because they are the same, except that the latter is only temporary. Types of anxiety disorders. There are several recognized types of anxiety disorder, and these are generalized anxiety disorder, GAD. GAD, generalized anxiety disorder, is a chronic disorder characterized by excessive worry and persistent anxiety about specific situations, life events, and objects. Patients with GAD experience anxiety and frequently worry about specifics such as money, health, work, school, or family. They are afraid, but they frequently face the challenge of determining the source of their anxiety and then controlling it. This unexplained fear may cause them to overestimate the situation. Contrary to popular belief, their actions frequently exaggerate the situation's gravity. Sufferers show a result. Sufferers believe and expect this. In many cases, this is a long-term condition, and sufferers are anxious in various situations. Anxiety is not usually a reaction to a single situation or event. On the other hand, patients with the condition will experience anxiety daily and may be unable to recall the last time they were relaxed. Restlessness and constant worry are two psychological symptoms of the condition. GAD is characterized by poor concentration and sleep. Panic disorder. A combination of physical and psychological factors causes this anxiety. Panic causes your body to react naturally, and you may feel emotionally overwhelmed by fear and apprehension. You may believe you are about to die, go insane, or lose control. Physical symptoms include sweating, feeling sick, shaking, or the sensation that your heart is beating irregularly. The development of phobias is a common side effect of panic disorder. These phobias can be complex, agoraphobia or social phobias, for example, or simple, fear of certain animals, situations, or bodily fluids, for example, blood, vomit, or injections being common examples. It is a type of anxiety frequently characterized by sudden or brief attacks of intense fear or terror, resulting in confusion, shaking, nausea, dizziness, and difficulty breathing. Panic attacks begin suddenly and peak after 10 to 15 minutes, lasting for hours. Any panic anxiety disorder can arise because of a terrifying experience or a stressful event, but it can also arise on its own. A panic attack also alerts the individual, who is usually aware of their changes. Individuals may interpret normal body function changes as a life-threatening illness to some extent. This erroneous interpretation may cause the individual to change behavior to avoid suspected illness and its associated attacks. Post-traumatic stress disorder, PTSD. Anxiety caused by traumatic events or episodes in the past, such as rape, military combat, a serious accident, hostage situations, abusive relationships, or an abusive childhood, is known as post-traumatic stress disorder, PTSD. People suffering from PTSD are often aware of their surroundings. Whenever a situation triggers a flashback, they suppress the fear of repeating the traumatic event. Individuals with this anxiety disorder are frequently withdrawn and may develop specific phobias and behavioral changes to avoid certain stimuli. This condition is usually brought on by real-life events that are serious and frightening. Examples include involvement in traffic accidents, violent assault, including sexual assault, witnessing violent events, military combat, witnessing or being involved in terrorist attacks, or severe natural disasters. Naturally, not every person who witnesses a traumatic event develops the disorder. Nonetheless, up to 30% of those involved in traumatic situations are likely to develop PTSD. Social anxiety disorder, social phobias. This anxiety disorder is distinguished by a fear of being in public places or social gatherings, negatively judged by others, or publicly humiliated. Individuals with social anxiety disorder frequently experience symptoms such as stage fright, speech anxiety, embarrassment, fear, and fear of intimacy. Patients with the disorder may also become withdrawn and self-conscious, avoiding contact with others or public places. Some people confuse this disorder with being shy, but the truth is that if you are always shy, you have this disorder. If you have the fear that the ground will open and swallow you whenever you are in public, you have a social anxiety disorder. This disorder can occur as part or independently of panic disorder. This is commonly referred to as shyness, but it is a much more serious issue. Making a phone call, going to the store, or interacting with others all cause intense anxiety. For those who suffer from a social anxiety disorder, the consequences are far-reaching, affecting relationships, careers, and education. Fear of losing control, humiliating yourself, or being rejected by others are common symptoms of the condition. Phobia. Phobia is an irrational fear that causes people to avoid specific objects or situations. People describe themselves as hydrophobic or claustrophobic, both of which cause anxiety. Every phobia has a fear reaction associated with a specific cause. Fear can be thought of as unnecessary or irrational. Separation anxiety disorder. This type of anxiety disorder is caused when a sufferer is separated from a place or person that provides a sense of safety or security. When a stranger physically separates a baby from its mother and attempts to take it to a distant location where the mother will be out of sight, this is an excellent example of this disorder.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.